Hey guys, today I want to show you how to draw a medieval dude that's going to be used on the monkeyhappy.com website. So let's go ahead and we'll pick our brush thickness, we'll draw the nose, adjust it with the selection tool, use the line tool to just close off any gaps to fill in with the bucket, and then do a little highlight, and then we can group the object so we can move it around later. We'll draw the head using a sort of an oval shape. Fill it in with the bucket tool and highlight again from the side just to make it look more 3D. Command G again, that's grouping the eyes, a separate object. You can smooth it out with the smoothing tool to make it look nicer as well. I like to do that often. Just double click over however many times you want to click it to make it smoother. So separate object again for the mustache, and here I'm drawing the hoodie, but I could have done this directly onto the actual head, but at first I thought that I would separate it into different layers, but I didn't by the end of it, so it doesn't matter. I drew it separately, and I can move it around and change it up later if I wanted to. It's the highlight on the side. Move the nose forward. Now I'm gonna just draw some patterns on the hood just to make it more detailed. Makes it look a bit nicer that way. And select the whole thing and put it into a object of its own and start drawing the body. Fill it in with the bucket tool. You can play around with all the colors you want there if you want a different color. And highlight on the side once again. I like to do the highlights, it just makes it look like it stands out a little bit more. It gives it a sort of an edge. And this is just adding on to the neck part. It's like a collar. When you do things in the group, separate objects, it makes it easy to add on things later on. As you saw there, I changed the rotation point on the head so that when it comes to animating, it turns at the neck. So drawing the legs there, convert them to symbols and put the rotation points at the top. That's when it becomes useful when you're animating the walking cycle afterwards. Now drawing the arm. Fill it in with the paint bucket tool. Okay, more highlights. I'll group this and then I'll draw the hand separately. That means that if I want to then change the position of the hand, just the hand itself, I can just do that without interfering with the actual arm. So here going inside the object, or the symbol, sorry, of the eyes, and I put two frames down to make him look like he's blinking. Just squash the eyes a bit on one frame and then squash him completely on the second. And that's enough when he's got squinty eyes like this to make him look like he's blinking. I copied the arm over from one side to the other. I flipped it and just so you've got two arms, obviously. And now I'm drawing the little pouch for the sword. Separately behind the character, obviously, and I'll group this whole thing. And then I'll draw the sword separately also, so I can remove it and lay it beside the character when it comes to using it inside the game. That means I could also animate him pulling the sword out if I wanted to, just using the brush tool and then the paint bucket tool. Using the selection tool to close any gaps. The smoothing tool just to smooth out the line if it works, or the selection tool to just adjust any tapers that I want. The highlights and the little shadows, black shadow, just to make it have more contrast. And as you can see, I can move the sword around freely now. can come out in and out if I wanted to. Now you turn all your different body parts into symbols, adjust your rotation points, the arms obviously at the shoulders, the legs at the top of the legs, the head at the neck, wherever you want the objects to be rotating, that's where you put your rotation point. And then you get all your body parts and you actually distribute them into layers. And because the character is just going to be standing and breathing right now, all I need is three different keyframes. So you just move the body parts around, the head moving it slightly back, the body making it slightly bigger, the arms up and down, just to make him look like he's breathing. So there you go, guys. That's him standing, breathing, blinking. I hope you enjoyed it. And thanks very much, guys, for watching, and see you next time.